Stephen Janiel Smith II. Amen. We thank God for all of the saints here gathered at Church the Lord's Harvest. Amen. We say praise the Lord to you this morning. Amen. And I was so elated, amen, to see Nana walk in the back. Amen. Let's give God a praise for her being with us this morning. Amen. I got your message. Amen. Thank the Lord. It's good to see Sister Fernandez with us. Amen. Knowing that God is still healing.
Yes,
amen. God is still delivering and making ways for us. Amen. Do I have a witness in the house this morning?
Hallelujah.
Amen. I don't know what happened over the Christmas holiday. Maybe you didn't get the plasma or the iPod or the dress or the coat. Amen. But God is still worthy
yes,
of the praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Elder Carter said Christmas 2009 is gone. She's taking the tree down. Amen. But one thing is constant, that our God is yet in control.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So I want you to praise him with me this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want to go out with a bang.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And give God the glory that he deserves. Hallelujah. Amen. Do I have harvest in the house
yes,
this morning? Amen. That's the sound that I was waiting to hear.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. If I don't have a cheerleader or praise leader, amen, I can praise him by myself.
All right.
Amen. Because he saved my soul. He may be in the process of saving yours, or you may be thinking about it. Amen. But I know what the Lord has done for me. Amen. And so we bless his name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I was, thank you, Mother. I was getting a little bit concerned.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Let's put our hands together. Thank God for the safe arrival of my dear mother. Amen. My sister. Amen. Let's go to the word of the Lord. Amen. 1 John chapter 3. Amen. Amen. I'm celebrating God for his faithfulness. Celebrating God just for who he is. Amen. Bless the Lord. Amen. I thank God for the presence of Reverend Shonda Nicole Gladden, who's with us. Amen. From Reed Temple. Amen. We thank God. Amen. To all the saints. Amen. My mothers. Amen. Mother Stevenson. Mother Smith. Mother Oates. Amen. I'm ready for those Christmas leftovers. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's go into the word of the Lord. 1 John chapter 3. First John chapter 3, verses 1 through 3, and the word of the Lord reads, "Behold what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure."
Amen.
Amen. Thus ending the reading of God's word. Amen. This morning we're going to look at the thought, the process of becoming. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm in the process,
of becoming.
Let's pray. Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. God, we take this opportunity, God, just to give you a pure praise, a pure adoration. We pray, Father, that at this time that we go into your word, we pray, Lord, that you would hide me behind Calvary's cross, that no flesh would glory. We pray, God, that you would arise and all your enemies be scattered. We pray now, God, that you would give us hearts to receive, ears to hear, and minds to comprehend. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The process of becoming. And as Bishop said, it is become customary here at the Christ Connecting Community that we, on the last Sunday of the year, amen, give us an overview and just to remind us of the ways and the things the Lord has done for us. As we are reminded, even in the book of the Old Testament, in the book of Numbers and Deuteronomy, certainly this was simply a retelling of God's faithfulness towards his people. One thing that I've learned in this hour and am somewhat baffled by is that the saints have a short attention span. Man, we don't remember things past the span of about 3 weeks. We hear great preaching, we hear great word, we have a great encounter at the altar, and just as soon as the next situation or trouble comes, we've forgotten where the Lord has brought us. 2009 is coming to a close, and we are positioned to yet go into another new year. A new year that is full of purpose, that is full of possibility, and a year that is full of promise. We, as the corporate body here at Church of the Lord's Harvest, have encountered much this year. Amen. I can certainly attest on the personal level and even on the corporate level, we've experienced much this year. We've seen the hand of God and we've seen his divine providence move on our behalf like never before. Jesus Christ continues to be our healer. He continues to be our deliverer, and he continues to be the way made. Yeah. We have seen his faithfulness and his sustaining power even in the time of famine and economic crisis. Amen. Even through the loss of jobs, the loss of investments, the loss of other material goods, God has proven that he ultimately is our source and our supply. Do I have a witness there? Amen. Amen. They may have come and given you that pink notice, that pink slip. They may have come and turned off your cable and your cell phone. They may even have come, amen, and started to initiate foreclosure on your home. Uh-huh. Amen. But even in all of this, God has been there for you. Yeah. Hallelujah. Individually, we have enjoyed spiritual highs and we have endured emotional lows. There were times that we walked in overflow, that everything seemed just to be all right. And then there were other times when we couldn't even see one way out the next. Amen. But in it all, God is to be praised that we've had enough.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
David testifies in Psalm 37:25. I once was young and now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Nor his seed begging bread. We can glory in the truth that we've made it through it all, and yeah, God has been faithful. Even in the press, we've not only survived. You know, people have the mentality, oh, as long as I can make it, as long as I can make it through the gate. Amen. But God has not only caused us to survive, but he's called us to thrive in the time of the famine.
Yes, Lord.
2 Corinthians 4:16 reminds us, for which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. Amen. And so if we would take, amen, the approach to look at our lives and not just look at those things that are temporal, those things that are temporary, those things that are external, but really look at those things that are spiritual, yeah, that yet remain. Here at Harvest and in the world abroad, we've experienced, amen, the blessed privilege of such historic events. We've seen first that we've never thought we would see before. Right. Amen. The inauguration of President Barack Obama. Right. Amen. The miracle that happened on the Hudson. Amen. Even here at Church of the Lord's Harvest, the consecration of our founding pastor to the bishopric.
Yeah.
Amen. A man 35 years old. Amen. Elevated in the Church of God. Can we put our hands together and celebrate God?
Thank you.
Amen. We oftentimes, amen, take these things lightly. Amen. Yeah. But it is a privilege and an honor to encounter these things that we've seen.
Yeah.
We've had life-changing and life-challenging words that have come to us through Church of the Lord's Harvest,
yeah,
that has equipped us to be the, yeah, Christ-connecting community. In this hour in the church, it's so much easier to do a thing rather than it is to be a thing.
Yeah.
Amen. But in the process of the